Rawahu al-Bukhari.
Respected brothers and sisters in Islam, as we have been reminding ourselves about Ramadan, that Ramadan will come and very, very quickly will go. And unless we run with Ramadan, we will miss and we will not be able to get out of Ramadan what a Muslim has to do that. And obviously, it's not only the month of fasting like many people understand. It is a month where all five pillars of Islam are practiced. So you will immediately ask the question, how come Hajj? What is Hajj? Hajj is nothing but dua. The most important part of Hajj is standing in Arafat and making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Ramadan is the month of dua. And dua is mukh al-ibadah, it's the essence of all worshipping. So brother, it is running very fast, and probably today is the Jum'atul Wida. You know, it is possible that next Friday may be Eidul Fitr. So we need to very consciously make this program that remaining 7 days, I will not let any moment pass by me without filling it with a good deed and with a good word. Good deeds and good words, not according to my thinking, but to match the role model of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Last 2 weeks we were speaking about the most important aspect of Ramadan, that is spending in the causes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are concluding that today, and we are going to speak about two more things inshallah if we have time. Laylatul Qadr and I'tikaf, because these are the things which are very deeply connected to the last 10 days of the holy month of Ramadan. And last 10 days are extremely important. Why? Because according to the division which is given to us by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, first 10 days are rahmah. Yeah, you are wrapped into the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Second 10 days are maghfirah. You receive the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the third 10 days will be freedom from the hellfire. And the real success is for a believer who can free him or herself from the hellfire. Because in other words, hellfire means displeasure of Allah. Hellfire means your lack of commitment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and lack of following the role model of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So let us conclude. I have some very important point. First point is from Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 261. You can read from 261 to 264, but 261 is extremely important, because in today's world, in modern world, everywhere people, they only spend money when they are 100% sure that I am going to get a return for my money, a return for my investment. See, and the return which is promised in this world, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سَبْعَ سَنَابِلٍ فِي كُلِّ سُنْبُلَةٍ مِئَةُ حَبَّةٍ وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. Meaning that you will get minimum 700 times return for whatever you spend for the causes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You spend a penny, 700 pennies. You spend a dollar, $700. You spend 1,000, 1,000 will be multiplied with 700. But the verse doesn't stop there. You see, at the conclusion of same verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. And Allah will multiply those 700 manifold for whomsoever He will. So according to the use of the money which you are spending in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, according to the benefit you are providing, according to the fulfillment of the needs which are, you know, completed by your money and by your financial participation. And another verse, and every verse of the Holy Quran, we must always read. My father, who was a great alim, he always used to say that whenever you read Quran, connect it with Zalikal Kitabu La Raiba Fih. This is the book which has no shadow of doubt. If Allah say you will get the return of 700 times, you will get the return of 700 times. If Allah says in Surah number 34, verse number 39, وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُ. Whatever you spend, Allah is going to replace it. Replace it. You know, if you have in your account 50,000 and you spend 25,000, it will be replaced, whatever you have spent. And this is the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you have to believe in that. If you don't believe in that, we are not Muslim. Then we have to reiterate, recommit ourselves, and say it again, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Next point is, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hassinu amwalakum bi zakat. You know, protect your wealth by paying zakat. And the word, you know, Hassinu, it comes from Hisn. Hisn is a qala, is a fort, you know, which cannot be penetrated. No thief can take your money away if you continue to pay your zakat. Number two, Wada'u, in the same saying of the Prophet, Wada'u mardakum bisadaqa, and treat your sick people by paying charities. You know, if you pay the charity, you get recovery from the sickness. And the third thing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said was, wastaqbilu bala'a al-amwat bid-du'a'i wat-tadarrub. You know, and whatever calamities, whatever waves of the hardship and calamities hit you, you can deal with that by praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making dua. And if a dua is done in an arrogant and proud way, just sitting and saying things, that is not dua. The major part of dua is at-tadarru'. And at-tadarru' means you need to show that you are faqir. Allahu ghaniyun wa antumul fuqara. You are begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So show the sign of begging, and to show the, you know, tears are coming out of your eyes and you are crying. And in one of the hadiths, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you cannot cry, then at least fake it. Look like the people who are crying. If you continue to do that, then realities will hit you and you will start doing the right thing. The next part is, in one of the sayings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, As-sadaqatu tasuddu sab'ina baban min ash-shar. Charity closes 70 doors evil. That may include all kind of evil, hardship and calamities. That is why it is important. And one more thing I'm telling, and then we move to Laylatul Qadr. It's never released, but the last year is, according to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, again, as-salatu tuballighuka nisf at-tariq. Your prayers will take you to the half of the way. Was-sawmu yuballighuka bab al-malik. Your fasting will take you to the door of the King of Kings. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the most important part is, you know, sometimes people may reach their destination, but doors are not open for them. You know. So, وَالصَّدَقَةُ تُدْخِلُكَ عَلَيْهِ. So your charity will take you inside, and obviously inside the Jannah, which is the place of appointment for a believer with the meeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters in Islam, we cannot emphasize more than this, because stinginess and greed destroy the faith of a person. Where the stinginess and greed are there in the heart of a person, it cannot be combined with the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if there is no love of Allah, there is no love of creation of Allah. And if there is not these things, then how can a person be a believer? You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Holy Quran, and hundreds of times we have repeated through our khutbas, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. Those who believe, they are strongest in their love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In these last 10 days, we have a night, and that is a very powerful night. You know, such a powerful night in a very short period of time, because nowadays the days are longer, nights are shorter. You know, a very short night, but the value of it, in the glorious words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Laylatul Qadri khayrun min alfi shahr. You know, that is surah number 97, verses 1 to 5, if you read that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is first mentally preparing you, telling you, inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr. The Holy Quran was revealed in the night of power. And Holy Quran being the prescription for the peace and justice for the humanity, it is the greatest gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, in order to make you understand, go deeper and deepen your knowledge about it. Allah says, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. It's not something that you can just easily understand. What will make you understand? You have to go deeper and deeper and deeper into the role model of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in understanding the value of Laylatul Qadr, this night of power. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. And in order to make us understand, he said, it is better than 1,000 months. 1,000 months. In few hours, you get the reward and thawab of over 83 years worth of deeds of righteousness and words of righteousness. Few hours only. What time is suhoor nowadays? 4 o'clock. What time we end the Tarawih prayer? Around 12. Within 4 hours, if you stay engage yourself in taking, you know, the time to review your life with the intention of connecting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his true followers connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will bring you the reward of over 83 years. You know, 1,000 months in one night. But do not be like that young man. See, a young man came to me, one of my students, he said, so it's okay for me if I stay in the night of power, then I don't have to do anything. You know, because it covers 83, who is going to live for 83 years? It has covered my life, so I don't have to do the prayer or fasting or zakah or hajj or anything. I'm already a winner. So brothers and sisters in Islam, my question to you, which I asked him and he understood, was, can a bonus replace your original salary? No. You have to register with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to do five pillars of Islam. You have to be regular in the prayer. Like if you are working in a factory, sometimes the factory has done so good business, they give you 6 months salary as your bonus. So this is the bonus. Your regular work will make you deserve entering the garden of paradise, but going higher and higher and higher and deeper will be these bonuses which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept for you. That the bonus doesn't replace the actual salary. These extra nights rewards do not replace your duties and responsibilities which are named as al-fara'id. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever is stand in prayer and devotional work, obviously at the night of the power, because it is called night of the power because of the power of 1,000 months, at the night of the power, Imanan wa ihtisaban, two things. You know, you have to have faith. You have to believe that it is better than 1,000 months. Wa ihtisaban means you have to expect a reward, thawab from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to believe that it is being counted with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If with that you do that, then all your previous sins will be forgiven. غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ. But in Islamic terminology, whenever you read the word, all sins will be forgiven, it is speaking about small sins. You know, a big sin, kabira, will never be forgiven without the tawbah. And if the kabira involves the right of somebody, you have violated somebody's right, you have taken a loan from somebody, you know, that has to be given back to get the proper forgiveness and maghfirah, because huququl ibad are extremely important. And if you do not fulfill all the huququl ibad, then your deeds of righteousness will not even be valid. So those are the debts we have to continue to fulfill. And suppose if you are engaged in the night of the power and you receive, you are so lucky that you come to, you know, like in the words of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu ta'ala anha, who was asking, if I am lucky enough to get the truth of night of power, how do you get it? You feel as if you are near the angels. You feel as if you are visited by Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam. You feel something that cannot be described in words. And if you reach that status, then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha that when you are in that condition, then pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this very important and powerful prayer. You know, like Allahumma innaka afuwan tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. Oh Allah, surely without doubt you are the one who grant the forgiveness and you love giving of forgiving people. So please forgive me. Imam Tirmidhi has reported that. And Sayyida Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha also describing the last 10 days of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she said, كَانَ النَّبِيُّ إِذَا دَخَلَ الْعَشْرَ الْأَخِيرِ شَدَّ مِئِزَرَهُ وَأَحْيَى لَيْلَهُ وَأَيْقَضَ أَهْلَهُ. رواه البخاري ومسلم. Both have reported that when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to enter the last 10 days of the holy month of Ramadan, he used to become extraordinarily prepared, you know, like you're tightening your belt, you're ready to go. That is shadda mizra. And ahya layla, he used to revive the nights. He did not sleep in those nights, but he did not limit those devotional work to himself. He also wake up the members of his family and let them join that thing. Now coming to the third part, brothers and sisters in Islam, that is i'tikaf. I'tikaf. An i'tikaf is a very important deed of righteousness in Islam in general. Like in general means whenever you enter masjid, you should always say after saying the dua of entering the masjid, I hope you know that, Allahumma inni as'aluka min fadlik wa bi rahmatik. Then you say, nawaitu sunnat al-i'tikaf. I intend, you know, to spend whatever time I'm spending in the masjid as a retreat, as an i'tikaf. And i'tikaf is doing something or is staying in some place bi niyyati taqarrubi ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the intention of gaining the nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obviously, gaining nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be with the good words and with the good deeds. And good words and good deeds, the list of them, if you want to know, that is in our sources of Islam, Quran and Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did engage himself into the i'tikaf in the last 10 days of the holy month of Ramadan in the masjid. And it is sunnah mu'akkadah ala al-kifayah according to Islamic jurisprudence. The meaning of that is, it is a sunnah, you know, a tradition of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which not only he did it regularly, but he instructed his followers to do. Like we have sunnah muakkadah, 4 rak'ah in salatul dhuhr before the fariḍa, and 2 rak'ah after that, like that. Meaning, if sunnah ghair muakkadah, it is optional, there is no blame on you. If sunnah muakkadah, if nobody does, in a locality where there is a masjid, the whole community will be considered sinner and will be blamed for that. So it is sunnah muakkada ala al-kifaya, means if a section of the community, even 1 or 2 persons engage into the i'tikaf, they have freed the whole community from, you know, the blame. And they have done and revived the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the time is coming to an end. So let me just conclude with a story I have told you many times before, and I love that story whenever I speak about i'tikaf. It is Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, you know, who was engaged into i'tikaf shortly after the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Masjid al-Nabawi, in the mosque of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And while he was, and you know i'tikaf, there are a whole lot of etiquettes of i'tikaf. One of them is, you're not supposed to leave the masjid, you have to stay in the masjid. Let your family bring you your food and your needs of the life. So this is the most important part. Keep it in mind. So Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, when he was in the i'tikaf in the masjid, a Muslim came who was worried, who looked grieved. So he said to him, "Oh my brother, araka muktaiban hazina. I see you grieved and worried. What is the problem?" So he said, "I have certain dues on me, but I cannot repay them. And the person is insisting and demanding on getting that." So Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he says, "I know that person. Should I go and intercede for you, speak to him about you to give you more time, or even forgive the debt for you?" So the man said, "In case, if you want." So immediately Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma started wearing the shoes and leaving the masjid of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the man said, surprisingly, "Yabna amma Rasulillah, O cousin of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, have you forgotten? Anasita ma kunta feet? Have you forgotten that you were engaged in i'tikaf? How can you go outside the masjid?" So Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma said, "Wadama'at aynahu," and his both eyes were overflowing with the tears. And he said, "Not too long ago, I heard Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that if somebody goes and fulfill a need of a prophet, of a brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will create, as a result of that deed of righteousness, a gap between him and the hellfire, which is a distance of 10 years, and he will make between him and hellfire 3 trenches, each one of them is bigger than the distance between the heaven and earth." So brothers and sisters in Islam, all the deeds of righteousness, all the pillars of Islam, the essence of the Holy Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the essence of the messages of all the prophets and messengers, is to bridge the gap between the rich and poor, to take the notice of the needs of the needy people, especially distressed, especially those who have no other sources. If you do that, then in reality you are following the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the footsteps of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where a highest possible deed in the holy month of Ramadan, such as i'tikaf, it was understood by the cousins of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that it is not more important than fulfilling a need of a brother who needs your help. So brothers and sisters in Islam, Islam teaches the humanity to be connected with each other on all three levels. Siblings with humanity, siblings with faith, and siblings of our blood. Let us with this beautiful message pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept whatever humble the work we are doing in our day-to-day life, and may Allah guide us to fulfill our responsibility in understanding and reaching the level where we can say with the same importance, you know, the things, and see other people with the same importance as we see our own need. That is the description of iman. Let us Allah pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant a speedy recovery to all the sick people, and maghfirah and forgiveness to all those who have passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed month bless Muslim Ummah by bringing them together in unity and bringing their hearts together. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us by solving all the problems of the Muslim Ummah everywhere in the Muslim world, and all the problems of the humanity which is up against itself and self-destruction. May Allah guide the humanity to come back to their senses in this blessed month of Ramadan. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'ir al muslimina fastaghfiruh innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إرغاما لمن جحد به وكفر وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله سيد الخلائق والبشر قال الله تبارك وتعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من صلى وصام وصلي على محمد وعلى آل محمد بعدد من قعد وقام وصلي على جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والصحابة أجمعين والتابعين وتبع التابعين وسلف الصالحين وأولياء الكاملين وعلماء الراسخين إلى يوم الدين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم وحد كلمة المسلمين. اللهم ألف بين قلوب المؤمنين. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين. اللهم اغفر لجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله رحمكم الله. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى أعلى وأولى وأعز وأجل وأهم وأتم وأعظم وأكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة